My name is Burton Blay. I'm the head of research and development at the Ottawa Laboratory Carling of the Canadian Food Inspection Agency. So our laboratory provides research and development support to our testing labs, and our main area of focus is in the area of detecting and identifying the presence of pathogenic microorganisms in foods. Well, what's been really interesting here is I've actually seen some of the techniques that were developed in our lab be implemented in supporting foodborne illness events that are occurring across the border. They'd had an actual outbreak. People were actually sick in the U.S. So they were doing a big investigation, and normally when that happens, we'll start testing the product here to make sure that we're not importing the problem. That's the impact right there, is that this, fairly major product brand that was clearly causing illness in the States, it was coming into Canada, and we wanted to make sure that what we're importing wasn't contaminated. We were able to do some very, very quick testing and determine that, yep, it's contaminated too. So that's it. We're not selling this to Canadians. You know, we're not going to allow Canadian consumers to be exposed to this. Genomics is a relatively new science in which we seek to understand the genetic blueprint of microorganisms. If you use the analogy of a house, it would be like having the blueprints and the scantlings for a particular house. So you would not only, of course, see the exterior manifestation of that house, but you would also see the detailed floor plan and the materials that went into its constructions, and perhaps even details of its engineering properties. And so genomics basically gives us that kind of very highly detailed perspective of microorganisms. In a foodborne illness outbreak investigation scenario, genomic techniques have proven to provide great advantages. We now have access to technology that enables us to very rapidly and accurately determine the entire DNA sequence of a microorganism, like an E. coli or a Salmonella bacterium. Getting out a high-resolution DNA fingerprint, you can actually determine whether or not a contamination event is of a sporadic nature or whether it's of a more persistent nature, a more long-term chronic contamination of a food manufacturing environment. And knowing this can make a big, big difference in terms of what the appropriate risk mitigation protocols are that should be applied to deal with the problem. I find it really gratifying to be able to see the kind of impact that the work we're doing is having to solve actual problems and to see that we're actually preventing illness in Canada because of some of the tools that we've developed. There are a number of different areas where genomics will help us to do our job as food inspectors a whole lot better. One of them is being able to have a better understanding of why some organisms are more pathogenic or more dangerous to human health than others. And so that'll help us to really refine our inspection activities so that they're targeted towards those scenarios that present a higher risk to the public. And I think that ultimately that will improve the effectiveness of our food inspection approaches.